Pam does a lot of work around here at the church. She's on the youth team here at the church, praise our kids. You know, the kids is our future, so we got to keep them up under our care. And Grave Chapel's been blessed with a chef, George. Thank God for George. I know Ms. Brown loves that because she can get out the kitchen now. But thank God for George. Like I said, I can go on and on talking about these two, but the most important thing is, though, that they are children of God. So let me introduce the song, present to others, Sister Pamela Pitt and Brother George Matthews.
Thank you. Marshall Park.
Father God in heaven, thank you. As I look around in this church, I see so many men and so many women here worshiping you. As we celebrate Men and Women Day, it's wonderful to know that there are so many men that want to say, thank you, our Heavenly Father, for giving us another day. There are so many women that want to say, thank you, our Heavenly Father, for giving us another day. Thank you for days that you give that's not promised to us. Thank you that we have a church that we can go to that celebrates on many different occasions. Thank you for Men and Women Day. Thank you for men and women who make up this world. God, you created men and women a long, long time ago. And that's a blessing for each other. We thank you for that blessing. Thank you for this day. And God, we ask if you'll just come in the midst. Come in the midst of this right now, of this ceremony. Just come, sit down, have your way. Let every voice hear that, raise a voice that sings out, that speaks. Let it come from their heart. We ask that you just touch their hearts. Touch it in a way that when you make it new, you regenerate. And when by regenerate, you show us. You show us just what we are able to do if we call on you. And we call it on you to come in the midst of this right now. God, knowing that there's nothing too great for you. There's nothing too small for you. And if we ask, all it takes is just for us to ask. God, we ask if you'll come on. Come on. Come right here, right now. Come here, our Lord. We call on you to come here. Come here and let us sing to you. Let us praise your holy name. Knowing that if we just continue to put you first and foremost, everything else is secondary. And by being in his place, you will make everything right. So God, we come and ask you right now, if you just come here in the midst of our Men and Women Day, take over, take charge. God, and let us have a hallelujah good time. We pray this in all things in your Son Jesus Christ's name. We continue to pray and ask forgiveness, ask for growth, and ask for a clean heart.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God our Father,
As for us, we have this large crowd of witnesses around us. So then let us rid ourselves of everything that gets in our way. And of this sin which holds on to us so tightly. And let us run with determination to the race that lies before us. Let us keep our eyes fixed on Jesus.
Amen.
On who our faith depends from beginning to the end. He did not give up because of the cross. Contrary, because of the joy that was waiting for him, he thought nothing of disgrace of dying on the cross. And now he's sitting on the right side of God, on the throne. I read for you Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2.
Amen. Now we will be favored with the selection from the Grace Chapel Choir.
Thank you.
welcome so that you will feel comfortable. But we're all in God's house, but we're gonna go by protocol. So we will have a welcome by not Vanessa Reed and Tommy Reed, but Tasha Reed and James Reed.
Amen.
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 All right.
I'm going to read the welcome. You're just going to stay here a little bit. All right, before I read the welcome, I'm just going to say, you came out looking for a perfect program. I'm sorry, you're the wrong church. You came out to have a hallelujah, throw your wig off, keep your shoe, good time. You in the right place. We are glad that you are here with us. If this is your first time worshiping with us, we are grateful that you have come to be with us on this evening. On behalf of our pastor, Reverend Charlie F. Stembridge, Sr., the pastor with the most swag on this side of the railroad track, you are welcome. Here at Grace Chapel AME, we are Bible-based. We are led by the man of God who preaches the word of God to the people of God. It is our hope that you experience the love of Christ and his presence as we are in full celebration of our annual Men and Women Day. We thank God for your presence. If you're in the area of Alcova Trussell Road and the doors of Grace Chapel are open, you are welcome to enter in. Again, thank you for sharing this special occasion with us. And once again, you're
welcome. Let the church say amen. Today is a good day.
It is.
Before I bring on this next selection, I just want to say thank you, and I want some people to be recognized for this. People on the hospitality committee, will you please stand? The ones who helped out in the kitchen today, will you please stand? All the way down to back there in the row. Come on, stand up, ma'am. We just put ourselves along with me in a better position. But it's just not only me, and I want to say to y'all, really thank you.
Amen.
So,
amen.
Thanks so much. Now we're gonna have another selection. This is gonna be about Mr. Daniel Jackson.
Amen.
Thank you.
Jackson.
Aye.
You can get a ride with Mr. Green this week, Sunday, Sunday off. Get a ride with him. Make sure you pray for him. Make sure you pray.
I got
you. That's all right. That's all right. At this time, we're going to introduce the Queen, Princess, the Sister Sarah Award, and the layperson. We're going to start off, before we do that, we got to do the recognition and honor by Ms. Tasha Pitts Reeves.
Like bro, Matthew said, I will introduce our queen, the princess, and Sister Sarah, and then I'll do my recognition and honor. Our queen for 2016, in her absence, was Her Majesty Miss Mildred Maddox. The princess, in her, she's here, stand Miss Mackenzie Thomas. Y'all give a round of applause. Our Sister Sarah Award was Miss Wavonia Reed, in her absence. And the late person of the year was Miss Lavonia Baker, in the back. Thank you, Ms. McKenzie. Everybody like to be recognized and honored. I want to give each and every one here today a special appreciation award. It's not a certificate. It's not a monetary offering. It's not a trophy. But it's something you can take with you each and everywhere you go. My special award today is two small words. And it says, thank you.
Amen.
I want to tell you thank you. But it doesn't seem like enough. Words don't seem sufficient. I could stand here all day and go blah, 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 blah. And all that good stuff. Please know, I have deep feelings for each and everyone here today. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming out and showing us your support. We really appreciate you. You're very special, and that's a true fact that no one can take away. Thank you.
Amen. On that note, we're going to have another selection by a group of young ladies and men that Ms. Brown speak highly of. They call the Voice of Wisdom. And she also is there like to eat too.
Yeah.
We sing that today too. So if you would just give them a nice round of hand to the Boss of Wilson.
God.
Glory is to our God.
today.
Yeah.
That's what y'all program say, you're thankful today.
Yeah.
Now, I don't believe in coming to a dead church.
Yeah.
I believe what the scripture said. It said, let everything that has breath praise you, Lord. Then it said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Now, see, like I said, it ain't my time to get up. Now, see, we're not here to pump you up. Y'all here to help me. See, if you misunderstand what it is, you here to help me preach. But if I got to help you praise God, I don't mind. You let me know what you want to do. Can we do that one more time? Can we do that one more time?
At this time, we're going to have an offering and gift. But every praise, that's something else. That's something else. And Brother Cody, you don't have to be a guest speaker here. You're always welcome. You're not a guest.
Amen.
It's your home.
Okay.
Yes. At this time, once again, I said we're going to have an offering and gift. And give whatever your heart receives. Because I just got filled up just here.
Amen.
Oh,
Now it's time we're going to have the introduction of the speaker by Brother Reed.
Good afternoon one more time. Let me introduce our speaker for today. He's a native of Walton County, Georgia. He was born to the son of Mr. Edward Cody and Miss Annette Clark. He received his education in the social service school system. He was accepted to Christ as his personal savior at the age of 5. And he received a gift of music at the age of 9. And during this time, he began his musical ministry in 1996. Well, in 1996, he was accepted for his calling to ministry. He was licensed to preach in August of 2003 and was ordained in 2007. His ministry training theological was at the Fellowship Bible Institution and Sanctuary in Riverside, California, and the Grand Canyon University of Phoenix, Arizona. This guy been around the world a little bit. Minister Cody served as the Minister of Music and Social Minister at the New Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church in Marietta, Georgia. He's doing that in 2004 to 2010. He pastored the New Word and Praise Worship Center in Covington, Georgia from 2005 to 2008. He is the father of 4 children and loves fishing and boating. He wants us to know that through his worship and ministry of music, he is committed to serving leadership. He strives to proclaim the good news of God's love to help us encounter Jesus through praises and worship. So will you stand to your feet as I introduce you to Reverend Edward Cody.
Thank you.
not afraid to call on the Lord in here. Well, let me pause a question to you. Isn't it good to call on somebody that you can't be disconnected from? Maybe you missed that. Let me say it again on this side over here. Isn't it good that you can call somebody that you cannot get disconnected from? And let me ask the whole church this. Isn't it good that you can call on somebody that you don't have to pay any money to? It doesn't matter when you call them. You can call them in the morning, in the evening, in the midnight hour. Isn't it good that you got somebody that you can call on? I want to have some church up in here. See, Reverend Sibley, it ain't good to get a Baptist preacher up in a Methodist church. See, that will become Baptist cost the folks here. See, I'm like what Grandma used to say, you know, when I think of the goodness of Jesus, and all that he's done for me, my soul cries hallelujah. Let me help God right there. Not blessing me with a new house, not with a new car, but thank you for saving me. Well, I can't hip hop belong to a noisy crew. See, I believe that anything that dead needs to be what? Dead. Now let me ask you this in here. Who in here is dead? Church is home, but I have two. But see, let me help you out. Now, there was a man that we know named Jesus.
All right.
Who was tempted for 40 days and 40 nights in the wilderness.
All
right. Let me sound sophisticated for those of you that are very well educated. He came down through 42 generations. His mother was named Mary, his father was named Joseph. Okay. He knew his purpose why he was sent here. All right. His purpose was he come to save a wretch like you and I.
Yes.
Sound all right, Reverend Stanbridge?
Yes.
Okay. Now, for you country folks, the man that we know, Jesus, who died for us over 2,000 years ago, you know him, right?
Yes.
We want to lift him up today. It's not about you. It's not about me. But we want to lift him up today. Why? Because he allowed men and women to come to church not to fuss, not to argue, but to praise and lift him up.
That's all right.
Let me get to it because it's pulling on me here.
Come on.
Pastor Stembridge,
yes,
ministers on the roster, good friend Apostle Milligan. That's probably a protocol. But those of you that have your Bible, I got to get here. Out of the Old Testament writing, let's go back to the 2 Chronicles.
Okay. I
chapter 7.
I hear you.
Verse 14.
Come on.
2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. Say amen if you have it.
Amen.
And it says, this is what God is saying. He said, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Now, to pin a subject on this, what you normally used to, people giving you a subject, we want to talk about the three D's.
All right.
Back then, Channel 5 had a slogan.
Yes, sir.
Their slogan was dedicated, determined, and dependable. Yes, so that's what we want to talk about today.
All right.
Dedicated, determined, and dependable.
All right.
Is that all right?
Yes.
First, you may take your seats, but I don't want to build from them. I want to build from this song, from this writer. And the title of the song was says, Lord, I'm available to you.
Yes.
This is where I want to build from. See, this is what us, the people, are saying to God here. We're saying, you gave me my hands to reach out to man. To show him your love and your perfect plan. He said, then we said, you gave me my ears. I can hear your voice so clear. I can hear the cries of sinners, but can I wipe away their tears? Then it goes on and said, you gave me my voice to speak your words, to sing all your praises to those who never heard. But with my eyes, I see a need for more availability. I see hearts that have been broken. So many people to be free. Then we said this, Lord, I'm available to you. My will, I give to you. I'll do what you say do. Use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to say my storage. My storage is empty and I am available to you. And then we said, now giving back to you all the tools you gave to me. My hand, my ears, my voice, my eyes. So you can use them as you please. I have emptied out my cup so you can fill it up. Now I'm free. I just want to be more available to you. And then we say again, Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say do. Use me, Lord. We say that mighty boldly. Use me, Lord. And then when he uses it, we want his back out from him. To show someone the way and enable me to say my storage is empty. And I am available to you, Lord. Now let me help you out. Before you can get there first, you got to recognize who you are first of all. You got to know who you are first of all before the Lord can use you for anything in his service. Now, do we have any self-made man in here? Any self-made right woman in here? Raise your hand. All right. Because I remember reading here where it said God created man and woman in his image. That's what he said. Now, I want to point out 9 things and we're going to get out the way. It's what, 4 o'clock now? Now, if you help me say amen with an appointment that is good, I'll be through at 4:15. And the one that have been with me, knows me, will be through in 15 minutes. But if you don't say nothing, I'll stand here until you get a revelation of what we're talking about. Now, don't fool me now and just say amen because you want to hurry up and get home. Man, the truth is the truth. Then we say amen together. Let me do a little quiz right quick. All right. I'm sorry. Listen, I woke up happy this morning. So, if I seem strange and doing some crazy stuff you ain't known or seen, I'm sorry. Maybe you need to fire your God. And you need to hire mine because mine is a joyful God. All right. Okay, you back here. Say amen.
Amen.
You over here say amen.
Amen.
You over here say amen.
Amen.
You over here say what?
Amen.
You right here what?
Amen.
Over here.
Amen.
So that means everybody's on one accord, right?
Amen.
So if an amen come up, if you ain't got it, your partner got it. Same way over here, if you ain't got it, your partner got it. So in other words, if you say amen, we'll be through in what, 14 minutes now. Nine things of 2 Chronicles 7:14, he said, if my people, that's the first one I want to talk about. If my people.
Yes, sir. All right.
And we can find that out in Psalms 100, verse 3. He said, know ye that the Lord, he is God, and is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people.
Yes, sir.
And the sheep of his pasture.
Right.
See, if you don't know who you are, God is telling you who you are right now.
Yeah. All right.
He said, you are my people,
well.
And in the sheep of my pasture.
Yes, yeah.
How many of you ever seen the green, you ever seen such a green pasture?
Oh, yes.
But how many of you know that there's a pasture that don't have to take no kind of chemicals on it?
See,
this is what God is talking about, that pasture, that green pasture he's talking about. We are his people. Now, we still got other things we got to do. Then he said, once we know who we are, then he says, enter into his gates with what?
Thanksgiving. Amen.
And into his courts with?
Praise.
Then he said, be thankful unto
him.
And bless his
name.
For the Lord is
good.
His mercy is ever.
Blessed.
And his truth endure it.
Forever.
All generations. So that means now we know who we are. We are God's child.
Yes.
So that means you, Pookie, Boo-Boo, them, everybody's included. Come on, somebody. It wouldn't be right, you just only worry about your own household being saved. Yeah, them cousins did me wrong. Yeah, I want them to be saved too, Reverend Hill. So that means we are his people. That means all the generations, that means them folk that we ain't even gonna see that gonna come after us. They gonna be God's people. Lord have mercy. The second thing, which are called by my name. Now, we know that some of us, we call on everybody but God. We only call him when we get in trouble. You know, when the bank account is running over, all the bills are paid, you able to go out and buy a new car. You know, able to sport yourself around in the Covington Square, let the sun roof down.
Well,
you know how we do sometimes. But why would you want to broadcast something that God has blessed you with for your own glory? If you know you can't afford that car, and because God loves you so much, he trusted you when you took care of that Pinto. Y'all know what I'm talking about, yeah? You took care of your Pinto, you kept the oil change, you kept the tires rotating, and now God said, he took care of that car, so now I can bless him with another car. With the sunroof this time.
Okay, now.
You know what I'm talking about? So, you can really appreciate God while you're in your suffering because you know that he's going to get the glory.
Amen.
You can't tell me that it's fun going through while everybody else is having fun on your expense. Come on now. Which are called by my name. 2 Timothy 2, 1 and 9. It says, y'all bear with me, I ain't got my eyes with me when I left me home. You ain't got to be a seasoned person who can't see. Second Timothy 1 and 9, it says, who has saved us and called us with the holy calling.
All right, yeah, holy calling.
That means he called y'all from the darkness into the what? Marvelous light. Not according to our works. Come on, say our works. Because of some of the stuff we do, no. But according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began. See, God was looking out for us before we even came here. And some of us have the audacity to come in the house of God and say that we did all this on our own. But then you want to call on the name of God when you start losing stuff. See, I don't know about you. Yeah, I'm going through, I'm going to praise God. But when everything is going better, I'm going to show enough shout. Come on, man. Why get quiet when you got everything going your way? That's when the world need to know that you serve a risen God, a risen Savior. Then he says, shall humble themselves. Let me stop right there. Chris,
come on now.
If I get talking about that, you probably want to go out there and start the car. Because I've learned that dealing with us is hard for us to humble to anything. Come on, somebody. Don't act so religious now. He says, shall humble themselves. That means you're so bold and mighty that you can't humble yourself before God? Let me make it even simpler for you. You're so bold and so educated that you can't do what your pastor asked you to do? Let me try it on this side over here. You're so well educated that you can't do what your pastor asked you to do? Let me come over here because y'all look at them strange. Now let me ask you. Now, if your pastor wants you to help clean up the sanctuary, do you have a problem with that?
No.
Y'all look like y'all got it over here. Y'all been looking so humble right there before me already, and I'm not even God. Y'all got it over here, don't you? But God is looking for a humble person so that he can use. See, God can't use any kind of person he don't want to. He can, but he won't. See, God can't use no stiff-necked Christian. Let me help you with that. Stiff neck. That means they can't tell you what to do. You're gonna do what you want to do. Instead of you saying that this is God's house, you're saying this is my house. My family's been coming here for years. My name is on the board back there. And you can't make me move nowhere. See, that's gonna come up being stiff neck, hard. You know that type of person that done been in prison about 40, 50 years, they come out and bust and stuff. You can't tell me nothing. See, they have something about Christians. We get like we so puffed up and all this and that God can't tell us to do something that we don't want to do. But let me tell you something. The same God that helped get you there will be the same God that'll bring you there. But guess what? For his glory. Shall humble themselves. And what it said, humble themselves and what?
Pray.
And pray. Oh Lord. There's another touchy subject for us.
And pray.
And pray.
And pray.
Let me help you. she in business no more. But you don't go call them sorcerers, them soothsayers. You don't go call them. You call on nobody but the name of Jesus again. Don't pray when everything is going well. How about you praying for your next door neighbor? It said, pray without ceasing. That means that you don't never stop praying. Even when you sleep at night, the Spirit makes intercession for us. So the Spirit in you that is already praying. And see, when you wake up next morning, you wonder why you're feeling so great. Because the Spirit has been praying on your behalf. You're supposed to pray for one another. That's what Jesus said. He said, pray ye for one another. That's like he said, love ye one another. So instead of gossiping about your next door neighbor because they're going through, pray for them. Pray that whatever they're going through, that God will lift them out of that situation. See, there's a song, a quartet song that came out a long time ago. It said, it's like pouring water on a drowning man. See, church folk love that stuff. When they see one of their fellow Christians going through, they instead of pouring the water all over them. And then they want to pray for them. No. That's not how it works, people of God. It said, humble yourself and pray. And then he said, and seek my face. Not your next door neighbor. I know you love Pastor Stembridge. But Jesus says, seek his face. Because there are some things that Pastor Stembridge can't do for you, but that only God can do for you. Let me watch the preacher. I know you can testify this. And then when the preacher don't move because we say move, then we get mad with him. Because it's not him. It's who we should trust in. God. That's why so many Christian pastors now is trying to take their lives away from themselves. Because of, I'm not going to point no finger. Because. You put yourself anywhere in the because. You understand what I'm saying? That's why so many Christians don't come to church. It's because. We seeking everybody else's face. We talking to everybody else about this and that person, but we're not talking to the one who we need to talk to, who is the Creator. Then he said, turn from your wicked ways. Some of you think about the sins of the thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor.
All right. Yeah.
But how many know you're telling a lie? What about backbiting? What about laziness? How about gluttony? You know, you can get a lot of folk come to you say you got a demo going on. But see, we only focusing on the sin that we know that are written in the Ten Commandments. But if you study and read more, it's other stuff. Lasciviousness. Whoremongering. Yeah, we know about adultery. That's what Jesus said. When you think about it, you already don't commit it in your heart. So let me help you out. So you ain't got to physically touch nobody. But if you think about it, you've already done it anyway. Then what I hear from heaven, you can't hear from heaven if you're in your mess. Let me let that marinate for a minute. Some people put it like this, God ain't gonna bless no mess. Because it's supposed to be an exclamation point. But we want to come to God in a question mark form. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay. If God is the head and he's pouring out oil, so if you got a question mark mentality, it's not gonna hit you what? It's gonna hit back here. But see, now you're ready to receive the oil of God. Because now you're in the exclamation point. So when he begins to pour, then it'll run down. Even at the
yes sir,
you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
But in order for that to happen, you got to give up some stuff that is wrong in the eyes of God. See, you can't come to God any kind of way and expect God to pour out a blessing upon you. You can't come to him talking about your next door neighbor and when you ain't right yourself. See, somebody wrote a song that they talk about a lady. They said, "Her house is so nasty. Why is her house so nasty? We need to go talk to her." But somebody else told her, "Baby, if you want to clean your windows, you'll see your house the one that's dirty. Your next door neighbor's doing crap. Turn from your wicked ways. Turn from your wicked ways. Let me see. Turn from your wicked ways." See, we got to understand that the devil is moving around now. He's doing a lot of stuff now. And see, he just wanted to find a willing vessel. And see, then he going to talk to the church folk. You know what I mean? He going to talk to us. But see, we need to stand flat-footed and tell the devil, "No, I would not bow down to your wicked ways. You would not get me to talk about them. You would not get me to say them." We need some Christian that is not afraid to stand up. See, it's been so many of us with jellyfish mentality. Say one thing on Saturday, try to be bold on Sunday. Then Monday, we can't find you, got your tail between your legs, running and hiding. Tuesday, you got your head buried in the sand. Wednesday, you're depressed. Thursday, you're taking pills. Friday, you're trying to commit suicide. Saturday, you're calling on a preacher. Then come in Sunday, you want to lift up your holy hand. Nobody like that in his army. Turn from your wicked ways. When you turn from your wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will begin to hear the voice of God when he begins to talk to me. See, sometimes we wonder why God is not talking, but what are we doing? We think we're in the dark. But guess what? God sees everything. So everything that's done in the dark will come to the light. I don't care if you blow your light bulbs in your house, blow your head bulbs on your car, take them out the inside of your car. Guess what? God still sees what you do. But until you give up some things and hear his voice, then his promise said that he will forgive your sin. That means everything that you have said, everything you have thought about saying, the thing that you have thought about months ahead that you want to do, he's already forgiven you for your sin. And he will heal your land. That's what he said that he's going to do. He said, "And I'll heal your land." So if we can do all these 9 points, what I just brought out. Now, I'm going to take my seat. I went over. I'm sorry. But I'm going to take my seat now. Up until we recognize who we are, who we're called by, who we're going to humble ourselves before and pray and seek his faith and turn from our wicked ways, then we will hear from heaven and we'll forgive their sin and we'll heal them. Then we can say we can operate in the 3Ds. Then you can say that you are dedicated. Yeah, I know this just men and women that we come to celebrate, but can you be dedicated Monday through Saturday? Can you be dedicated when they can't reach the pastor, but they call you just for advice? Yeah. you dedicated enough that when the pastor calls you come open up the doors and it's raining on the outside? Are you dedicated enough to come? See, I'm like this. If you can't, if I got to beg you to do something for the Lord, then why do I need you? That goes back to humbling yourself. Then you will be determined, have a made up mind. That means nothing will sway you to move either way. You know that going to the left is going to be wrong. And you see that going to the right is going to be wrong. But you determined to walk the straight and narrow path. Let me tell you what that word means. It said having a firm decision and being resolved not to change it. That means when you see you're going through something, are you still determined to go through it anyway? And dependable. Lord Jesus. That means, are you trustworthy?
Yes. All
right.
And reliable.
Go ahead.
That means, in the time of need, can God depend upon you to pray for one another?
Yes.
Are you dependable enough? When you see your church member need a ride to church,
come on now.
Can you bring them to church?
Yeah.
Are you dedicated enough to let your light shine before men that they will glorify your God in heaven?
Yeah.
That means that you being dedicated, that means you showing loyalty and integrity to God. Not to Grace Chapel AME Church, but to God. Are you determined to go all the way with Jesus Christ? That means when you're going through hell and high water, can't see your way out. Are you determined enough to go through the storm? Are you dependable enough that God can trust you when you're going through that? He know that you won't walk away from it. Can God trust you that much? So I want to ask you today, can God trust you with the three D's? Not just because it's men and women there, but are you dedicated? Are you determined? Are you dependable? Let me help you if you don't understand. I know there's another man who walks straight in the three D's, and his name is Jesus Christ. He was dedicated to the cross. He was determined to die for a wretch undone. And he was dependable because he said, in 3 days. He said, in 3 days, I'm going to get up again. See, that lets me know that Jesus was dedicated. He was determined. And he was dependable. No, I'm not saying they're going to hang you to a cross, but are you dedicated enough? Are you faithful to the cause of God? Are you determined to do what God called you to do? Not everybody's called to be a preacher, but you are called to be a witness. That means you can tell your story instead of keep your story to yourself. Are you dependable at the time you need to tell your story? Are you willing to tell your story? And are you willing to tell your story truthfully? Dedicated. Determined. And dependable. God bless you.
Cody, we thank you for that message. Yes. Powerful message. Church, you got to ask yourself when you leave out the door, are you with the three D's?
Yes.
Are you dependable? Are you dedicated? And are you determined?
Yes.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have the financial report. Thank you. Invitation to the Christ disciples.
Mmm. Jehovah. I said, guide me over, thy great Jehovah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Pastor, for that wonderful message. We come here to have a good time on Men's and Women's Day. And Sister Brown said we'll go home and sleep tonight. I was going to sleep in the house, but I'm living together now. Before we go, I know we've been here a long time. Is the choir going to sing another song? And is it some other song you're going to sing? Did y'all have a finished song? Y'all good? Okay, good. I just, somebody had told me y'all had another song. I'll be real brief. I don't be up there long like Pastor Cody when you give me a few moments when I sit down. But I want to thank all the preachers for coming out to be with us today in the pulpit and out in the audience for being here on this Men's and Women's Day. That guy, Misfit and Master Sam, all for doing the first time. They did a wonderful job. Thank you. We have a few members in the church and they're willing to work as he was preaching. I was thinking what he was saying, the one down here. They feel free to fill in all time, whatever your needs. So thank you all so much. Brother Matthew had been too long to join the church, but he had let his feet hit the ground. He's been running and working even a bit. Amen. Amen. Thank all you for being here all day for the morning service. Some of you behaviors that Sunday school in the morning. Thank you so much for staying here with us today. Thank this special choir today. Y'all come from the depth of y'all heart. Yes, sir. I want to thank my choir for opening up. Thank you again so much. Now I want to thank this great preacher for today. He came here today. He said he was happy. When you serve God, you serve God right. Amen. You're supposed to be happy. Amen. You can't preach when you ain't happy. Amen. I don't believe you're saved when you're not happy. Amen. You can't worship when you're not happy. Amen. Let all of you be happy. Amen. And last thing, we've been reading, Pastor Reed said, two words. Thank you so much. Thank you for your finance, food, committee, everybody who made this possible work today. Thank you so much. Mr. Dim Bridger-Everwood. Reverend Hill, you easy in on it. Song that song. You want to say something, y'all?
I just want to say to the church and all the ones that are here, God is beautiful. Yeah. And I want to say to this young man that brought my message. Really, he was hitting on a lot of stuff I preached about this morning. Good God Almighty, that's what the Spirit does. Amen. 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 I've been praying for it. Amen. I'm praying for the day that God will help you up.
Thank God. Amen. I just want to say thank you for the invite. Well, you know, I'm glad to be back. This is my second time preaching in Grace Chapel. And it's been long time ago. So Grace Chapel feels like it is home for me as well. Amen. I certainly enjoyed myself being here. And I want to thank my babies, the voices of wisdom.
Amen.
Y'all for coming, and I want to thank my dad and his wife for coming here today as well. And as always, had mama in the house with me as well. Amen. And then also my good friend Apostle Steve and his wife, thank y'all for coming.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Everything is said, so let us all stand. Oh, Lord, have mercy. I'm having a senior moment. And my aunts, my aunt Jeanette and my aunt Willie, thank God, too. I'm so sorry. So you don't have to be old to have a senior moment. Amen. him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power both now and forevermore.